Hola, community, it's Pablo Vasquez. Today we are not going to talk about 290, 91, and the future versions. We are talking about the long-term support release, the one that is based on Blender 2.83, and it's been getting fixes, bug fixes, for the last few months. Even though 2.90 is already out, 2.83 LTS is still getting fixes. Today there is a new release, and I'm making a video because it's a very special one. All of the releases are specials. If you go to the LTS page in Blender, blender.org/LTS, you're gonna see that every bug fix release that it's been out like nearly every 2 weeks or 3 weeks sometimes, it's getting lots of fixes between 15, 20. The last release got 30 fixes, and the reason I'm making a video about it is because it's the only release to include also a new feature. But it's a new feature. I know, Pablo, you're not supposed to include new features in a bug fix release. However, this is not a Blender thing, but it's more of a Steam VR thing. So yes, Steam VR is now supported by Blender, by OpenXR, which is the library that runs Blender's VR internally. So if you check the wiki, the manual, you're gonna see now that head-mounted displays. This is the manual for 290, but it also applies to 2.83, that Steam VR for Windows and for Linux, it's available. It's a beta preview, it's a developer preview. So beware, might have some issues, but it means that you can now use HTC Vive and Valve Index. So Steam VR is a big thing for supporting even more devices to use with Blender. So yeah, that's the only reason I'm making a video. Also to let you know that there are ways to update automatically. We still don't have a way internally inside of Blender to do it, but you can use the Windows Store version, which is a new link, by the way. It's a new version of Blender that you can have alongside your 2.90 release, for example. You can have the 2.83 LTS, and this is gonna be updating automatically on every new point release, every new fix release. For Mac and Linux, you can also use Steam, and for Linux, you can use Snap, which is also updating automatically. On Snap, you can choose it from here when you select it, 2.83.6 released today. And for Steam, you have to change the branch. So in the project, in the item Blender, you can right-click properties and open the betas tab and select the LTS program for 2.83 or the 290, whatever you want to use. And this is because at some point there will be two LTSs running. 2.93 LTS next year is gonna exist alongside 2.83. That's why they're coexisting. So yes, go play with it. I'm sorry, I don't have a Valve Index here or an HTC Vive to show you, but it works. And that is the magic of using like open source libraries like OpenXR. Super cool. All right, enjoy, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.